First of all, what are the numbers? Kisko bolte hain numbers?
What do we call number? Or what do we
know as number? So numbers are basically used to represent size, quantity, or to measure. Okay. Or if we have measured or counted two things, we can compare them. To compare, we use numbers. For example, how many students are sitting in this class? That will be 30, 40, 50. Okay. If I say what is the distance between Baroda and Ahmedabad, the answer would be 110. Which room is bigger, this classroom or the other classroom? So what will you do? You will measure the length of the class. So let's say 40 feet. The other one is 50 feet. So the 50 feet is bigger, right? So this is 50, 110, 30. These are all numbers. Okay. Other situations. If a company does some business and you say that they have done a profit, so how will you calculate? You will use some numbers again. You will find some the total revenue, total collection that they have done, and the total expenditure that they have done. So the difference is positive. That means we say that there is a profit. Or if the difference is negative, we say that there is a loss. So again, we are using numbers. Okay. Now here we'll stick to a little basic things only. Numbers can be primarily divided into two types: real numbers and imaginary numbers. Real numbers are those numbers which actually fulfill this purpose. Now I'll explain. You will understand that when you see what exactly is the meaning of imaginary number. So basically, real numbers are all useful numbers. So things which look like numbers and they're really useful. Okay. Those numbers which look like numbers, but not useful as numbers. As of now, you just need to understand any number which is square root of a negative number is called imaginary number. For example, we all know the square root of 9, that is equal to 3, or minus 3. We'll see later the significance of these two things. As of now, this is just say that square root of 9 is 3. What about square root of minus 9? If it is square root of minus 9, you cannot find the square root of minus 9. Okay. What will you have to do? You will have to break it like this. 9 into minus 1. Square root of 9 will be, so this can be separated as we are aware about this rule. Root of A into B can be written as root of A into root of B. So we take these two things as A and B. We can take them as root 9 into root of minus 1. Root of 9 is 3. Root of minus 1 just as it is because you cannot find root of minus 1. You cannot find the value of root of minus 1. So because we cannot find anything for this further, or we cannot resolve this further, what we do is we take the first letter of the word imaginary. The first letter of the word imaginary, that is I, and we give this a name I. So this can be presented as 3i. So where I is actually root of minus 1. So I use this space. I stands for imaginary and it is equal to root of minus 1. Okay. That means I square is equal to minus 1. Okay. If you further square it, you will get I to the power 4, which is equal to 1. That's the maximum that you need to know about imaginary numbers. Other than this, that is not important for us. Okay. Now let's come back to real numbers. Real numbers are those which are very useful for us. Okay. Now, real numbers further can be divided into types. So as we are just saying that any number which is useful, they're all real. So real can be further divided into two types on the basis of their usability. Or you can also say on the basis of their presentation. Okay. Real numbers can be further divided into two types. And from here, actual work for us starts. One part is a rational number. Okay. The other part is irrational number.